नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड बिजनेस स्टडीज चैप्टर 1 मैनेजमेंट ऑफ बिजनेस। एक्सरसाइजेस। फर्स्ट मेन आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस इन ए सेंटेंस। फर्स्ट वन, व्हाट इज मैनेजमेंट? आंसर इज द मैनेजमेंट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ गेटिंग predetermined things done through the efforts of others. Second one, what do you mean by decision making? Answer is, decision making is the mental process resulting in the selection of a course of action among several activities. Third question, what is individual decision and what is collective decision? Answer is, in small business organizations like sole trading concerns, it is the individual who takes the decision. They are called individual decisions. Decision making by a group of people, as in the case of partnership firms and board of directors, as in the case of joint stock companies or cooperative societies, are called group decisions. Let's move to question number 4. What is the principle of authority and responsibility in principle of management? Answer is, this principle refers to the authority and responsibility which are the combination of official authority and personal responsibility. Both are compounded with intelligence, experience, past experience, moral worth, etc. These are all about the principle of authority and responsibility in principles of management. Let's move to second main. Answer each of the following questions in about 4 to 5 sentences. First one, what are the principles of management suggested by Henry Fayol? The principles of management suggested by Henry Fayol are division of work, authority and responsibility, discipline, unity of command, unity of direction, subordination of individual interest to general interest. Seventh one, remuneration of personnel, centralization, scalar chain, equity, stability of security to personnel, initiative, spirit de corps. These are the principles of management suggested by Henry Fayol. Let's move to second question. What are the functional areas of management? The functional areas of management are, first one, planning, second one, organizing, third one, staffing, fourth one, directing, fifth one, coordinating, sixth one, controlling. These are the functional areas of management. Let's move to question number 3. Write about the authority and responsibility, scalar chain and centralization in principles of management. Answer is, first one, authority and responsibility. This principle refers to the authority and responsibility, which are the combination of official authority and personal responsibility. Both are compounded with intelligence, experience, past experience, moral worth, etc. Second one, scalar chain. This principle means that every enterprise should have graded authority or superior subordinate relationship. The range of authority and responsibility of superiors in relation to the subordinates at various levels should be clearly defined. Third one, centralization. This principle refers to the extent to which authority is concentrated so that it gives the overall yields. These are all about the authority and responsibility, scalar chain and centralization in principles of management. Question number 4. What is the need for decision making in management of business? The need for decision making in management of business are: each business organization has its own goals and objectives. In order to achieve these objectives and goals, the business organization has to take decision. There are number of choices available even in a small matter. Suppose a businessman has to transport goods. He has to take a decision about the mode of transportation, whether to send the goods through a truck, tempo, train, or by air. He has to choose one among the several alternatives, and that alternative should be best suited and economical. It is based on the decision which the businessman has taken. Thus, the decision making plays a very significant role in the business. These are all the need for decision making in management of business. Let's move to question number 5. What are the important elements of decision making? The important elements of decision making are establishing goals, defining tasks, searching for alternatives, developing plans, rational thinking and reasoning, situation evaluation. These are all the important elements of decision making. Let's move to question number 6. What factors are to be kept in mind while taking a decision? The factors which are to be kept in mind while taking a decision are time factor, experience, wise decision or wisdom, firmness, boldness, and clarity. These are the factors to be kept in mind while taking a decision. Let's move to question number 7. What do you mean by planning and organization in functional areas of management? First one, planning. It is one of the important functional areas of management. It involves the future course of operation for a given period. The process of planning includes determination of organizational objective and formulation of plans, policies, strategies, programs, procedures, and schedules. Next one is organizing. It is the process of bringing together the manpower and material resources. Some of the material resources are machines and materials. Putting the material resources and manpower together into working order to achieve the objectives is the main purpose of the organizing area of managerial function. These are all about the meaning of planning and organization in functional areas of management. Let's move to question number 8. How is controlling an important area of managerial function? Answer is, it is an important area of the managerial function. It covers almost all the management activities. It keeps check on other functions of management. It is a function that every manager in the organization has to perform. Let's move to question number 9. What are the main objectives of controlling areas? The main objectives of controlling areas are to create an atmosphere of order and discipline in the organization, to ensure proper coordination of activities, to ensure confirmation of actual performance with the predetermined plans, to achieve the increase of the overall efficiency of the organization. These are all the main objectives of controlling areas. Question number 10. Directing and coordinations are very important functions in business management. How? First one, directing. It is the area of functional management where instructing, guiding, supervising, and leading the people of an organization towards accomplishment of the organizational goals. It is issuing orders or instruction to the subordinates and make certain that the instructions are properly carried out and the operations are successfully planned. Next one, coordination. It is the harmonious blending of the activities of the different departments for the achievement of the desired goals. It is the arrangement of group efforts to provide unity of actions in the pursuit of common purpose. In this way, directing and coordinations are very important functions in business management.